the flats with dangerous cladding. There's a government fund that's meant to help pay to make them safe. Well, now a group of residents is taking the government to court because their block has been excluded from applying for money from that fund. It's because the people who live in the block in Manchester had already contributed themselves towards the repairs. Our reporter Melanie Abbott's been looking into it. So Mel, these government funds, they sound wonderful when they're announced, but there are obstacles along the way, aren't there?
Well, that's right. The first fund, which was set up 2 years ago, was only for buildings with exactly the same kind of cladding as that found on Grenfell Tower. So it turned out if you had the wrong kind of cladding, even though it was flammable, then you couldn't apply for any funding. That was put right with this new £1 billion funds for all unsafe cladding on tall buildings. But it turns out if you've been in any way proactive, then you can't apply for the money. Nathan Prescott is one of 98 leaseholders affected by this, and his name is on the judicial review.
You kind of really do lose all faith. It just is so unfair, it's unjust. The fire brigade were putting a lot of pressure on our freeholder to actually conduct the works as soon as possible to make the building safe.
Is there no way that the freeholder would be willing to pay up front themselves?
We have exhausted every avenue with both the freeholder, but also all the other areas such as insurance policies, people that had installed the cladding. We spent quite a lot of money on legal process.
Unless this judicial review is successful, you do face very large bills. How will you manage those?
I've spoken to many of my neighbours, some of whom have bills of up to £32,000, including a huge proportion of VAT. Mine was £18,574. I've managed to get 5 years, so it's still £309 a month on top of all my mortgage, service charge. I literally do not have any spare cash at all. I face redundancy, so at the moment they've allowed me a payment holiday on the actual cladding works. And whilst I appreciate all of the assistance that the government's given to many other people, we just want them to do the right thing now.
The government fund is designed to speed up this work by removing the financial barriers to it taking place. It could be argued that in your building's case, because the work has already started, that there is no true financial barrier, and therefore that's why the fund is closed to you.
Government with the ACM cladding have always maintained that the leaseholders who had no part to play in these unsafe cladding being put on their buildings should not be responsible for bearing the costs of the remediation. And I don't see why there should be any difference with the current building safety fund that we're trying to apply to and that was set up for the ACM cladding.
So that's what Nathan Prescott thinks. What does the government say?
Well, I did ask them for a response, but they have told me that they don't comment on ongoing legal action.
Well, they have said, though, haven't they, ministers, for a long time, that they think it's down to the building owners, so not the leaseholders, but the freeholders, to do the right thing, that they are the ones who should pay for this work. Have any freeholders done that?
There are some, but they are in a minority. Interestingly, a council in East London, Havering Council, has taken enforcement action against the freeholder of 8 blocks of flats with cladding and other fire safety problems, ordering them to take action. Now, the problem is that for most leaseholders, there is a clause in their contract saying that they are responsible for paying for this work. Chloe Bell has a shared ownership. It's a one-bedroom apartment in one of those blocks. The rest is owned by a housing association. She told me that she thinks this enforcement action is good, but things are uncertain.
When I found the letter on the doorstep, you always think, oh God, what's going to happen now? But I think I feel positive about it because more pressure put on the freeholder, then hopefully we can make the building safe quicker because we've been sort of stuck in the same position for a while now. I found out through my bank actually who came around to do an evaluation, and then they gave me a figure of 0. I hadn't even been in it like for nearly a full year. And then that's when it all sort of started to unfold about the cladding and about lots of other things about the building that I had no idea about.
What happens now?
I have no idea. We had a waking watch, a company that go around checking that the building's not on fire, essentially. But they've put in a new alarm system. So we've got an alarm now, which took away the waking watch, and that was about £460 per person.
Although this notice forces them to do the work, it doesn't force them to pay for it.
No, that is a really worrying thing. And to be sort of squished and said that it's now worth nothing and you're liable for all of this is just so unbearably stressful. I'm currently renting it out and I have gone and rented elsewhere just because I just don't really want to be in that flat anymore. I just regret buying this flat. Your first property is meant to be so exciting and such a positive step and you think you're doing all the right things, when in fact it's been the complete opposite, and I may as well have just stuck with renting a room because I'd be much safer and in a better place financially, which is really sad.
And Chloe's Housing Association have told me that they understand an application to the Cladding Fund is being made and they'll work with the freeholder's agent to provide any help they can. I did contact the freeholder too, but haven't heard back.
Melanie Abbott, thank you.